morning, Brad. We're talking about turtles and tortoises, and there's a lot to know about turtles and tortoises. And good morning. How are you?
Good morning.
How are you? You brought your grandchildren in.
I did, all the way from Arizona.
All the way from. Good morning, guys.
Hi.
Hi, good morning. And I see they're holding turtles, too.
They are.
And we're going to get to all this in a minute, but there's kind of a multi-purpose reason for you being here.
One
of them is the illegal trade, to talk about that, which is just horrifying. The other one is, of course, Dave Davis and Brandy on your newsletter here holding tortoises.
From our last July show.
From your last July show. And before we get to the actual, you made this for Dave Scott.
We did.
And wow. He's the only news reporter I know who actually can speak to a tortoise, and the tortoise speaks back.
Right, and he gets right at their level. Look at that.
And he gets right at their level. What a great shot. And this is on glass, which is just beautiful. He's going to love that. So, obviously, we've been involved with you guys for quite a while. You have pictures of us all over the place.
We do.
So, we're talking preservation, and we're also talking adoption.
We're talking adoption because we're getting hundreds of turtles and tortoises turned in right now. So we have an adoption event Saturday morning at Balboa Park, which is free to the public. And we welcome them to come down and learn about care, the types that are available. We have food. We have housing. We don't charge for adoptions. We just make sure the home is approved. So we have the California desert tortoise.
Let's start with this. First of all, let's give this tortoise his due. This is a famous turtle.
This is a famous turtle.
Yes. And now this one, tell us what happened here.
This is Mustang Sally, which was just featured on one of the Ford commercials that was done here. They came out here from Detroit. So we're proud to have that tortoise. It is available for adoption. She's about 15 years old, and we're just looking for a home that can adequately keep it outdoors.
Is that full grown?
It is. That's a full grown tortoise, about 14 inches.
Yeah, and a famous tortoise, too.
Famous tortoise.
So anybody who adopts this.
And this sign will be in the commercial with it.
Yeah, exactly. It says, "The Preserve, please help us protect our tortoise."
It is.
And so there you have. Did she get her Screen Actors Guild card or anything like that?
Did.
Seriously?
We have that.
You have a Screen Actors Guild card for the tortoise. I was kidding, but you're serious. All right, well, good. That's the way Hollywood is. Young man, how are you? What do you have here? Can you tell us?
It's a Russian tortoise.
That's a Russian tortoise.
Yeah.
What do you know about him?
Not much. I just met him.
Okay, why don't you fill in the gaps for the Russian tortoise over here?
This is a great beginner tortoise. It's full grown, and he's easy to keep. He's pretty easy to care for. They do hibernate just like the desert tortoise. But it's a great little hardy tortoise that's pretty good for beginners.
When you say hibernate, what do? Dig a hole in the dirt?
They do. They dig a hole about November, and they come up again in March.
Oh, that's nice. I wish I had some friends like that. Hey, what about this one right here?
This is about a six-month-old baby desert tortoise. So he's going to get just the size of Mustang Sally. And we do have some of those available for the right person.
Now, do you find that people adopt these because they're little, tiny, and cute, and then suddenly they're huge, and they say, what am I doing with this tortoise?
A lot of times they're outliving the family. So we're getting them because the parents have died. They've had them 40, 50, 60 years, and the kids really don't know what to do with them.
Yeah, that's true.
The one that gets large is the one that's crawling down over here.
This one here. This one's been very active this morning.
Yeah,
and this is what type?
This is an African sulcata tortoise, and it's going to reach 150 pounds.
Oh, so that's the one that gets really big.
Yes, this tortoise right here is probably about 8 years old, and he could get actually up to 200 pounds.
I got to tell you, he's got beautiful markings.
He's got gorgeous markings. He's very strong. He's very aggressive, not towards people, but he's just a very busy tortoise.
Yeah. Speaking of busy, how about that one up there in the front?
That's a common red-eared slider, the kind that people get. That are very small, the size of a quarter, and he goes in ponds. I brought him today to show him because we've got about 50, 60 of those available for adoption.
So those are the ones you see in the pet stores that
are
the tiny
little
ones.
The little tiny quarter-sized tortoise.
And they get, is that full-grown or?
That is full-grown.
That is full-grown. So that's how big they get.
It is.
Wow. All right, let's quickly talk about the preservation effort. And this, this over here is an indication of what's happening here. You can see a chart basically from all over the world, and they're capturing turtles and tortoises and whatnot and sending them primarily over to China because it's a delicacy over there. And the numbers are really shocking.
Yeah, the numbers are shocking. They send about 50,000 a month through Los Angeles of the snapping turtles to eat.
50,000 a month?
Yeah, and some of the ones that we've had have actually been taped to pant legs. They've tried to smuggle them taped in socks.
So they're smuggling them like drug dealers.
Little babies.
Oh, my
goodness. Just little babies. They smuggled them.
Are they really worth that much money?
They are over there.
They are.
Yeah.
They really are. So what can we do? I mean, what can we do to stop these? And I understand they're... Some of these are actually farms. These are turtle farms.
These are turtle farms.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where they grow them and they send them. They grow them.
We just recently had about 300 come in from Fish and Wildlife, and they were from Honduras, and they were kept so terribly that about 200 of them died.
Oh, my goodness gracious. All right. Well, you
do
have an event on Saturday.
We do.
Over at Balboa Park.
Free. Everybody needs to come down and learn how they can adopt a tortoise. They're very easy. It's all on our website. We would love to have everybody come down. And we also would like to thank KUSI, a special thank you with a plaque from
yes.
us for everything you do for
well, look
helping
at that.
Us.
Look at how beautiful that is.
We
that
do
is
have so... guest speakers at 2 o'clock. Again, all that information is on our website.
All right. Well, thank you so much for this. It's beautiful. It says thank you for your continued support, KUSI. We will find a lovely place for this.
Thank you very much.
And for Dave Scott's as well. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
And you guys, good to see you.
Too.
Take care. All right. We'll see you later.
All the way from Arizona.
All the way from Arizona.
Just to see you.
Good to see you guys. All right. We'll take a break. See you in a minute.